Welcome to 5-Minute Einstein. Have you ever walked past an oily puddle on the road and wondered why it was rainbow? Today, we're going to explore the physics behind this colorful phenomenon. First things first, you may have heard that light is both a wave and a particle. Sometimes it behaves like a wave, and sometimes it behaves like a particle. This is called wave-particle duality. Weird, huh? For our purposes, we're going to focus on the wave properties of light. You can try to understand these waves by imagining waves that you make when you shake a skipping rope around. Here, we have amplitude, and here, we have wavelength. Be warned, though, light waves are fundamentally very different from mechanical skipping rope waves. Now, when light waves hits the boundary between one medium, such as air, and another, such as water, some of the light is reflected and some of it passes through this new medium. But we are more interested in the reflection part, because in oily puddles, instead of going straight from air to water, light has to interact with a layer of oil as well. This is the key to our rainbow puddles. The oil floating on these puddles probably came from cars, be it motor oil, gasoline, or whatever. It spreads out in a really thin layer across the top of the puddle. A really thin layer, and just another thing, keep in mind that white light from the sun is composed of a spectrum of colors, and that each color has a different wavelength. So, air to oil, some of the light is reflected. Oil to water, some more light is reflected. But since the layer of oil is so thin, there's barely a difference between these two reflection points. Barely makes a difference, though. The oil layer is so thin that it is comparable to the wavelengths of light, which are on the scale of nanometers. That's 10 to the power of negative 9. Real tiny. The light that is reflected from the boundary between oil and water travels a teeny distance farther. Because of this tiny offset, the light waves interfere with each other. Interference. When you have two light waves like this, they add together and become brighter. If you shift one of the waves behind by one wavelength, they still add together. This is called constructive interference. However, if you shift one half a wavelength behind, they subtract from each other and become nada, zero. This is destructive interference. Depending on how thick the oil layer is, the offset distance could be a full wavelength for some color, making it brighter, and it could be half a wavelength for another color, making it cancel out. This means that instead of seeing white light or all of the wavelengths, we see the dominant color or wavelengths, which could be red, or orange, or yellow, or green, or, you get the point. But we see a whole rainbow because the oil does not have the same thickness across the entire puddle, and each thickness causes a different color to interfere constructively and destructively. There you have it. I hope you enjoyed the video and learned something new. Thanks for tuning in to 5-Minute Einstein.